we're going to see if this is the best all-in-one Bluetooth headset.
What's happening, Panda Nation? Peter from Panda here. So I picked this up. It's the Jabra Talk 45. Now, if you have checked out my video from years past, you know that I have a Jabra Talk 55, and I really like it. But it actually has some disadvantages, and it's mostly around travel. So this Jabra Talk 45 might solve that for me. So I picked it up. I thought I would test it out. It does come with the cigarette lighter adapter here, comes with a micro USB cable, comes with a couple of additional earpieces and the ear loop, which is actually one of the things that I really like about the Jabras is that they're pretty comfortable. And it looks like we get two of those, two additional earpieces. These have the little hooks on them to kind of fit and wedge into your ear. I'm not a big fan of those. I like these. This looks like this needs to be rotated like that. But you can see it's pretty standard looking. It actually looks a little bit like an Apple EarPod because it kind of has this boom mic that hangs down here, but it's all very, very simple. As you can see, it's all black. You have this angular little silicone ear cover. You can see how it just comes off like that and goes back on. And so that should fit inside your ear, little cylinder here, the boom. You can see the little microphone holes. Looks like we have an LED light. We have some buttons here. And this is really what I liked about it. The Jabra Talk 55 has a little base, which is fine, but if you take that out and put in your ear, it always stays on. And so what I really liked is that this has a power button right here so that this is kind of self-contained. I can turn it off and turn it on without having a separate base. It looks like we have a little cover here. That's where you're going to charge it up. And then we have your little function button right here. A little clip here looks like it goes on by going around this base here. And I'm trying to think, I'll probably use this on my right ear, I would say. So if I do that, then I want to put it on like this. But you can see, I don't even have to take that off. Slips right around there. And now this will hold it on your ear. And the reason I want to try this is because it's always nice to have something to take phone calls, but I also like using these little Bluetooth headsets as lavalier microphones for shooting video, especially outdoors, because these are pretty good at canceling out wind. And so it just helps get better audio, especially when I'm outside of my studio here, so that the videos are just more enjoyable on the receiving end. So we're gonna try this shooting some video. I'm also gonna take a call on it and I will show you what that sounds like.
All right, so I've got the headset in and I've got it connected to my phone as the Bluetooth microphone. So I'm only sitting about 4 feet away from the camera right now. If I back up, I'm getting 5 feet. So this is the audio quality that you should expect from this earpiece. Now I've been playing around with it and I do like it. First of all, it sounds great. You know, it's what you expect from a noise isolating earbud that goes in your ear. I was playing a little music, listening to some podcasts. They all come across great. I would say that I wish the fit were just a little bit better. My ears are a little funny shaped, so they're probably not typical, but it doesn't really sit that well. And without this ring, I feel like it would just fall out. So I would absolutely use this ring for people with kind of abnormal ears. If earbuds fit in your ears perfectly, then this might be just fine. But I think my ear canal is a little small, so the ring is nice. It helps make sure that it doesn't fall out, and that is absolutely fine. I would also say that the controls are really easy to use. So I love that there's a physical power button on it. And the little mode button underneath is actually for activating the voice assistant. So when I hit it, it actually activates Siri on my phone, which is great because then I can actually have the dial out command or read me my calendar, which is really nice because I can hit it right there. There's actually a little button right here. This little panel actually moves. And so if I tap right there, that is actually the play pause control. So when I was listening to music, if I actually press that, it'll play pause it. So this is the audio that you're going to expect when you're listening through it. I'm actually going to call in my voicemail and leave me a message, and that's the audio quality that you can expect the people on the other end of the call to be hearing. All right, so this is the audio downloaded directly out of my voicemail, and so if you're making calls with this, which is probably what you should be doing, this is what audio quality the person on the other end of your phone calls should expect. And so I'm using it connected to my iPhone here, pretty good signal. And so this is a pretty good representation, I think, of all of the uses for this Jabra 45. So far, I like it, and I think it's going to be the one that goes with me when I travel just because, like I said, unlike the Jabra 55, which needs its base, this one does not. I can plug it into any micro USB cable. I can turn it on and off right from the device itself. So it's going to be nice, small, portable, and seems to do everything that I need it to do. If you want to pick up this Jabra Talk 45, I'll put a link to it in the description. Click on it there. Peter Ron Panda, out.